It's a place that's fueled by creativity and imagination. A place where adults with developmental disabilities can express themselves through the world of art.
Did you know you were in the paper today?
Yes, I did.
Oh, look at this.
And it all started on a cold January day back in 2003 with a dream and a leap of faith.
We really didn't have anything secured in place. We had a parent organization that took a big risk, Skills Society. Their board approved a five-year lease on a building, and we had no additional funds at that time. We found that it was hard to explain what we wanted to do with it. We felt people needed to see it, and if they saw it, they'd get it. And fortunately, that did work out.
Today, at 2 o'clock, you're going to be ready to go.
Yes. Wendy's right-hand man throughout the entire journey has been Paul Freeman.
Congratulations, you've made it 11 years. How does it feel?
Well, it feels really great considering that 11 years ago, we started with one artist and myself. And last week we opened an exhibition with 12 other Edmonton painters, and we're really being presented as equal to the other art production that's happening in the city.
5 years ago, the artistic hub moved shop to 118th Ave. And nowadays, upwards of 170 artists call this workshop a home away from home.
I do the outline, that's all.
Artists like Leona Clausen, a regular member who's been coming to the Nina since the very beginning.
I love this place. I like to come because my mind goes wandering.
You get to focus in on just the art, nothing else, right?
That's right.
One of the most unique aspects of this nonprofit is the idea that members are free to do what they want, when they want.
We try to create a place where people are really not being told what to do all day. You can imagine how if you're in care receiving services, you might spend most of your day feeling like you're being told what to do. But of course, as artists, we understand that that doesn't make very good work, and that people need the freedom to fail. So people here are allowed to make their own choices. That's the only way to make an authentic piece of art, anyway.
It's a practice that's churning out some amazing results. Can't wait to see what the next 11 years will bring to this one-of-a-kind shop.
I love the colors. They're beautiful. Definitely one of your favorite pieces.
Yes.
Reporting for Go Edmonton, I'm Angelica Gavrinsky.